Hi guys, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. And on today's tutorial, we want to estimate the number of gray roofing tiles that you can need. So we did sometimes back we did a tutorial on how to estimate the number of iron sheets, but on this one we want to look at the clay roofing tiles. How can you calculate the number of the tiles that you are going to need? So welcome back again, and then let's stay tuned here as we walk through the calculations together. Now you can see sometimes in this modern technology we mostly use the clay tiles or the roofing sheets, so it's also good to know both aspects of the roofing materials. So we want to look at these clay roofing tiles. Remember, there are different types of clays roofing tiles, but we are going to select one and then we are going to work with that one. So let's proceed. So before we calculate the clay tiles, we want to look at our gable roof that we are going to tile. So this is the length here and this is the width of the roof. So we have the overhangs here, we have the overhangs here, we have the overhangs, that is the eaves on the width, and then we have the overhang on the length, that is the on the gable side. So we want to get the roof area. So we are going to start by calculating the rafter length first, so that we can be able to proceed with the roofing area. Now this is our house that we want to roof, so we are going to calculate the area. So we are going to take a length of 12 meters and a width of 10 meters. So we need to get the total run. So total run is half the span of the width, that is a half the width which includes the heaves. So our width plus the heave, half of it is what gives us the total run. So we need the total run so that we can be able to get, and then we have the pitch, we have the angle so that we can be able to get the rafter length, this one here. Now we start by first getting the rafter length. So our eaves that are projecting on that side is 550, and then our verges is 400. So we have a width of 10 meters, then we have eaves. The eaves are on both sides, so on this side and on the other side. So we add to the heaves, that gives us 11.1 meters. So our run will be half the total width, that is half 11.1, that gives us 5.55. Now our rafter C, we need to get the rafter C here, and then we have our angle theta here is 30 degrees. So we need to get our rafter C here now that we have the run. So this run here is what we have, that is 5.55. So we need to get our rafter C. So our rafter C using Pythagoras theorem will be 5.5 divided by cos 30, that gives us 6.40. Now our rafter length here is 6.40. And then when we are laying the tiles, we'll need a projection. If you look at the rafter length is up to this point, so we are going to add this projection here, say 100. So we add that one, so that is 6.40 plus 0.1, that gives us 6.5 meters. So now this is going to be our new width that we are going to use to get the roof area. Now let's proceed to getting the roof area now that we have the width. Now for the length will be just the length that we had. The length of the building was 12 meters plus the overhangs, that is the verges, that was 0.2 on both sides, giving us 12.80. Now our roof area will be the length multiplied by the width, that is 12.40 by 6.50, giving us 80.60 meter square. Now for us to be able to get the number of clay tiles, we are going to get the roof area, we divide by the area of the clay tile, one clay tile, the area of one clay tile, for us to be able to get the number of clay tiles that we need for our roofing. Now our clay tile size here is 420 for the length by 300 millimeters. Now we need to get this clay tile, it has head laps and side laps. Now, head laps is when you are laying your clitals, they overlap. So they are overlapping on the side lap by 75 millimeters, and on the side lap here, they are overlapping by 30 millimeters. So for us to get the effective length, we are going to take the length of the clitoris, we subtract the lap, that is 75, that gives us 345 millimeters, that is 0.345, and then the width is 300, we subtract the side lap, that is 30, giving us 270 millimeters, that is 0.27. Now we are going to use this effective length and the width to get the area of one clitoris. So if we tabulate that one, 0.35 by 0.27, we are getting an area of 0.09315 meter square. Therefore, the number of clitoris that we need will be the roof area divided by the clitoris area. So our roof area was 80.60, we divide by the area of one clitoris, that is 0.09315, that gives us 365.27 clitoris. So approximately we need, that gives us 865.27. So approximately we round that to the nearest, that means we need 866 clitoris for us to be able to roof a 12 meter by 10 meter gable roof. So guys, that is how we go about it. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your support. Until next time, bye bye.